Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, here in Southern California, and good evening to those of you in Washington, D.C., and around the world, good night to those of you in Israel. We welcome you to this prayer time together. Are you muted over there, David? I'm getting a little feedback for some reason. All right, here we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we do thank you for joining us today. And by the way, if you'd like to join us by telephone, this is a communications channel. We call it the CCC. CCC stands for Congressional Communications Channel. Congressional because that's the top of the list. Communications is plural because we want to communicate with you, you with us, and us with God. That's what it's all about. This is a prayer meeting, and we welcome you. And we welcome you on behalf of the Congressional Prayer Conference. We welcome you on behalf of the First Baptist Church and Messianic Fellowship. We welcome you on behalf of David's Tabernacle. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, is when David's Tabernacle was first set up. It was a tent. The Hebrew word is tabernacle. And there are three main references to the tabernacle: Isaiah chapter 16, verse 5, Amos chapter 9, verse 11, the book of Acts chapter 15, verses 16, and also in the reference in Isaiah 16, 5, it refers to the tabernacle of David prophetically, pointing to one from the line of David who will someday sit on the throne over all. This, of course, is referring to Jesus. Welcome to the Jesus Tabernacle. Welcome to the prayer line. Welcome to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, and Brother David Myers is on with us. I'm here. My name is Wiley Drake, and I believe someone else just joined us. Do we have a caller on the line with us? All right. Is this Miss Vicki?
Hello?
Hello. Who is this on the line with us?
Goldie Moore.
Is it Goldie Moore? Oh, Goldie. Hey, God bless you. God bless you, Goldie, and thank you for joining us. And ladies and gentlemen, we've been working together with Goldie and with two of her compadres. Are they on the line with us?
Eugene is here today.
Well, hello, Eugene. How are
you? Yeah, I just do a boom with the San Francisco to see about the trial for that Lucida guy.
Oh, okay.
We got out with Goldie, and she's been doing a lot of good stuff over the internet, and we just wanted to tell you a few things else. But we've got on certain people here, too, and we're going to move further along with this.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what Eugene is referring to is the terrible shape that our courts are in. He saw it firsthand because they railroaded him because the courts were rigged. And ladies and gentlemen, I've been preaching that now for over 20 years, especially in reference to child protective services cases, and especially in cases where women and men have gone to the court and made a deal with the court so they can divorce their husband or divorce their wife or get their kids or get rid of their kids, all of those things, and the courts are rigged. Is that right, Eugene?
Oh, yeah, it's totally rigged. But you know what's good about my case is I won the $250,000 and got that. They still owe me maybe $500 million now because they didn't pay the rest of it. They try to keep me in court for 5 more years to get me to settle. Because when the book comes out and we show you the other stuff, it tells how they realize what could happen to the federal court system and the other court system when they have to hear the case in sociarum.
Yeah.
That means everybody gets their case. There's been tapes all over. What else we're coming forward today and saying, Goldie, you probably third on the internet, is a lot of these innocent projects are phonies. Because we have one of the guys who was head of the Innocence Project who knew about all this fraud, all the innocent men being in jail, but said he couldn't do nothing because the 8th Breast was the right judge up And he also ate with all the other judges, and he was friends with them. So you got the head of the one getting people out, being friends with the judges. It's him. Goldie's got the stuff. She's going to put it out. We're going to send her more stuff. And we even got some guys in the CIA telling stuff, just what's going to happen when this hits the fan. This goes into the Child Protective Services and everything else. Because in Chicago, it's got a different name, you know. It's got children and parents services, you know. It calls it just a little different. So in other words, Department of Child and, I think, Parent Services. So it's just like yours, but it's the same thing. There's a mother, a Spanish mother, it's now and there. So this is all over the country. But the key is what everybody doesn't understand is, us in this book is the only way to get out. You can take one judge at a time, but that's not going to work. You'll be dead by the time all the judges are done or they don't put a new guy in. You've got to get the Supreme Court to tell you there are the tapes and the master tapes and that you can have them. Then the people that have lost before, they get their records, their children back, everything is done. And this, when we're doing this, will eventually have you get your tapes. And then you won't be cheated by lawyers or anybody else because you'll know what's said firsthand.
Amen.
So basically, your lawyer then, or yourself going in there, will get your tape right after your very first hearing, deposition, or anything. And let you get it, stay there and get it right away. Don't let them send it to you through the mail or anything else. It won't be diluted like they did to our friend that's in jail there. You know, you're going to Green.
Yeah.
But she got tapes. There are no tapes. Now think about this. She gets her disc, but they're doctored up. Now she should be out of jail immediately because they doctored up her tape. So the point is, she can then go for the master tape, get that, and find out what the heck really happened. And that's what we're in the Supreme Court for. There's another couple of laws that you people don't know out there. If a wrong decision is given and it's held in the Supreme Court, they can cheat and cheat and use that decision, using the law the wrong way, until it's overturned. Like in my case, where you have to give you the tapes, then they have to go by the truth. And what you all must understand is those nine judges take precedent over every judge in this country. So if you're trying to get one out at a time, I'm sorry. You're not going anywhere with that. They'll just put another guy in there. You might get your children back in one or two cases, but the big percentage, you're going to be stuck. A big percentage of people are going to be in jail. You must cut off the head of the dragon. The snake must go.
Amen.
That's the only way you're going to do it. Think about this. I'm complaining, but I want $250,000. And I cashed that check. And I cashed the check because you know why? Because it was a check from a grant money, which they shouldn't have done. The minute I cashed that, they broke the law and used grant money to pay me in Chicago. So I'm sitting here and it destroys the whole system. Goldie will start putting things in there. She got the stuff in the jails today and that. But we're telling you that the people that are getting people out one at a time are the same people that put them in and are friends of these judges. And this guy is from Northwestern University, University of Chicago. Some of your top universities are the ones doing this, and we're going to show them too, and we'll have the evidence. Just like we went after Rosenthal. He hasn't made a move out of these judges. I mean, Pastor, he hasn't made a move or contact you, did he?
No.
And they won't, because bringing this to court will expose this, and everybody's going to know what's happening. Because right now, all the people out there, if they don't read the book and listen to what happened and see the evidence, they're all sleepwalking and thinking something else is going on.
Yeah.
Well, I'll give you back to Goldie. She can explain a lot of this, too, you know. So go ahead, Goldie. She's been a wonderful help. You've got to bless her, Pastor, because she's been...
Amen. Amen. Well, Father, we do bless Goldie, and we thank Goldie for what she's doing. Goldie, before you go into the details, many of our folks may be listening for the first time, and they've heard Eugene refer to a book. Will you tell us the title of that book and how they can get it?
Well, the book is The Death of the Justice System. It's volume, second edition, volume one. It has an audio tape. A tape recorder on the front of it, so it's definable. You can see it. I also have it on, I have three Facebooks that anybody can come and join Death of the Justice System. The cover of the book is on the page. You can see it clearly. And it's with my name, Goldie Moore. And they can come on and join me anytime they want and get educated to Eugene's book. They can get educated to the corrupt rigging that's going on in America.
Amen.
And share all of their information, how they were cheated.
Yeah.
And the patronage system is bigger than anybody can even imagine. They have to lie. They have to cheat.
Mm.
Okay? Because of the patronage. They're all Masonics. And in Eugene's book, it shows how they all work together.
Yeah.
This judge, that lawyer, the media, this, that. These are all part of this patronage system.
Amen.
And it's getting through to the Supreme Court with a tape, audio tape case and a fraud case is unheard of. They even told Eugene they're not letting anybody into Supreme Court with this kind of case ever again.
Yeah.
And that's why it's so important for people to understand look and how they themselves to follow them in.
Well, Goldie, you're absolutely right, but tell our friends, I know the title is The Death of the Justice System. Where can our listening audience find that book?
They can find it at crownopress.com. And www.crownopress.com. Thank you, Eugene. They can also find it on any of my Facebooks. I have the link posted. And they just click on Crown Oak Press, www.crownoakpress.com, and it's selling. How much is it selling for, Eugene?
It's $26.99, and the ebook will be coming out shortly in a few days, and that's only for $9.99, and you can get it right there. You can get it like in 30 minutes on your machine.
Everybody can get it. Everybody can afford this now.
Yes, amen.
They can share with their friends. They can get educated to the corrupt system and what's going on and how they get them themselves to win their own cases.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. In fact, the matter is, at the half hour, when we get down to the bottom of the half hour here, we're going to be going on another conference call line with some folks on a radio show, and we're going to be talking about one that I would encourage you all to go to the website. In all these kind of cases, you have to get the evidence. And the evidence against Obama in our Supreme Court case, the evidence that was brought against him was put together by Mike Volan and some other fellas. And that website for that evidence is wheresobamasbirthcertificate.com. Wheresobamasbirthcertificate.com. And at the half hour, we're going to be joining them on a broadcast and talking about that very case. And we thank you all for sharing this case with us. Folks, get this book. And this is not just your average book. This is a document, ladies and gentlemen, in book form. It's evidence. It's photographs. All of it there in this document that's titled The Death of the Justice System, and it talks about the corruption and the rigging that they're doing. And you can go to crownoakpress.com and get the book. And I would encourage you to do that. And I would encourage you by giving you an incentive. If you get that book, all you've got to do is call me up and say, Pastor Drake, I have the document in hand, and I'd like to talk about it, and we'll certainly give you free time on this television show around the world to talk about your experience with this document called The Death of the Justice System by CrownOakPress.com. Now, Goldie or Eugene, anything else you'd like to share? Go ahead.
If you want to put the book in as evidence, you can do that. And I ain't afraid to come and tell them right to their faces what they did. I guarantee this stuff is true. They know it. I know it. They know how it works because I grew up in the system. Everything in the book, I'll guarantee to anybody out there. and you want to put my affidavit, you want a deposition, yeah, it's fine. You can send it to anyone who wants. And I don't care. Because I'm not afraid. And they don't ask. They ain't gonna do nothing here. And the point is this is what it is, and it's got to be done. God protects what's right. So there's not a fear in this here. Everything in there, I guarantee it, and we'll write you a deposition in your case. You want a deposition, it's fine. I don't care. Right, Goldie?
Right. And your Jeep's book really works. It really does. Last week I was contacted by a nice young gal, and she was crying very hard because they said you were going to take her daughter away from her and adopt her out. She's going to lose her parental rights. I got her on the phone. She couldn't afford books, so I just explained to her really quick, do this, stuff I got from the book. And do you know, within 2 days, she got her daughter back.
Praise the Lord.
This week. It really works. The stuff, what Eugene teaches in this book is truthful, 100%, and it does work. I have other friends, you know, up in Northern California that are learning this and getting their cases dropped, you know, and they're learning how to find the fraud exactly like, which is how you can keep it in this book.
Amen.
And they're all ready to go. They're all ready to go. They can't wait to go to the Supreme Court with their fraud and get back what they lost and to expose the entire judicial system for the fraud and fake it is.
One more thing going to tell you what to do is remember out there, you guys, anybody that lost in any kind of case, if fraud comes up, there's no statute of limitation. And we have a preponderance of the evidence showing the fraud that gets you to master tape. But if you ask for your tape, you stay right there by that court reporter and you get it from her there. The time they take and say they're going to mail it to you, it's going to be doctored up like Wendy Green's, and I'll testify to this. And they're not going to say a darn word about it, but it's true. I'll sign an affidavit against them, and one of us has got to go to jail, and it's going to be them, not me. I'll guarantee it.
Amen.
Just like Joe Namath in the Super Bowl, I guarantee it is. On my oath to God, this is the truth.
Another thing, too, they only cheat one way. And it's in everything. The cheat game is in every case. You walk into that courtroom, you look at that judge, and you know he's going to cheat, lie, steal, doctor, fabricate, because that's his job. That's every judge's job. They're not there for justice. They're there to teach us.
Amen.
That's exactly what they're doing on a mass scale. You want to add to that? Oh, yeah, I know what I want to add. The prison system is fresh on my mind today because you read about these guys that have been in prison for 25 years on fabricated charges. These guys knew they were innocent, okay? A good population of the prison system is innocent because the judges, the lawyers, the attorneys, the DA all work together to make sure they get a guilty verdict to put these prisoners in jail for the prison system to make money. It's a big scam.
Well, you're absolutely right. It's one of the largest organizations of money making that we have in this country, and they're making billions of dollars at the cost of criminals. And we see it on a very small scale, and we see it on large scale. We see people abused by the system. I'll just give you an example of a very small scale. We had a guy here, for example, that walked down to the street corner here and crossed on a light that was already red, according to the policeman. It really wasn't, but he said it was. And it was the policeman's word against the homeless man. And he gave him a ticket for running a red light, walking on a do not walk. And he went to court, and when he was in court, they thought maybe they might make a deal. So what they did was they said to the guy, look, we've added another charge. We've added a felony charge. The felony charge is disobeying the orders of a legal officer, and that's a federal thing. That's a felony. And they said, but if you will just go ahead and plead guilty to the crossing on the illegal light, if you'll plead guilty to that, we'll drop the other charge, the worser one. And they do this all the time. They make a deal.
Yeah.
They're charged with one crime, and then they add another one to it, and they can do that anytime they want to. They add another to it, and they get a more serious one, and they say, oh, well, if you'll just plead guilty to this lesser one, you'll be out of here today. You'll be back on the street today. You won't have to go back to jail. You won't have this. You'll just have a simple misdemeanor on your record. You won't pay any fine. We'll give you time served, and you'll be out of here. All you got to do is plead guilty. And so many of these poor people, homeless people, ignorant people say, oh, yeah, okay, they're making me a deal. They're cutting me a good deal. So I'm gonna make a deal. They make a deal, and they walk out of court. But now they're convicted, and they shouldn't have been.
Pastor, that's the most perfect thing I heard you say, because that's how they get people for murder cases.
That's right.
If you plead guilty enough times and they let you out, Pastor, they got such a record that your record looks so bad when they force this stuff on you, you're gone for life or 20 years. That's the problem.
Yep.
Don't ever plead guilty to something you didn't do. Because in the long run, it's going to hurt you. That was perfect, Pastor. That's the thing you ought to run on. And I'm going to be serious with you. Here's the thing. I knew a guy, Orlando Cruz. He was on a TV show, and we got that on YouTube. And we were talking. And he had to have two bodyguards with him because he had to leave Chicago when they let him out. But we knew how to talk to each other from the streets. And I'll be serious with you. You can see it. And the point was, he told me that he'll come forward on what's really happened and what happened to him if we can get this and break this on the tapes and that. Because this guy was innocent for 18 years for killing a girl named Jeannie Nicarico. And then he was proven innocent. He got out after that for a while. And they made him leave Chicago. They didn't want him around here. But also, the ones that got him out, like the Innocence Project and that, are the same ones that put him in.
Yeah.
So here's the...
They're lawyers. They're patriots.
Here's the point. They look like they're doing stuff. You can say, oh, yeah, and then the press has to hug in one another and kiss and they're out. But here's the point. We got the one guy saying, I eat with Judge Duff. I like all the judges. I can't support the book because it shows what it is. Now, don't you think if these were honest men, they'd get everybody out at once? If they could show that there's fraud and you get your audio tapes and there's nothing but fraud here? No. They're just letting you people think something good is going on. It's not. It's just a way to hide from the real truth and effects of how many are innocent. How many children are being taken? When they get one back, they take 20. Is that right, Pastor? So in other words, where are you getting a break?
Yeah. You're absolutely right. Well, you're absolutely right. There is no break, you know, in essence. They're trying to tell you that there is, and there really isn't. But ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you that we are here on the Wiley Drake Show, and we're telling the truth. When we started this show back in the year 2000, we decided that our theme would be Micah 6:8 and Matthew 23:23. Micah said there's three things that are important. And then Jesus said there are three things that are important. And those three things, he is very clear about. Those three things that are very important are this: justice, mercy, and faith. Now, everybody knows faith is important. Everybody knows mercy is important. That's why we have a homeless shelter. That's why we have David's Tabernacle for worship and mercy. But, folks, all of that goes by the wayside if you don't have justice. You remember the Apostle Paul. They accused him illegally and unjust. And he said, how dare you come after me? I'm a Roman citizen. And he declared his rights. And we need to do the same thing. That's why we title this show, our motto for this show as justice, mercy, and faith. And both Micah and Jesus, when they listed those three important things, they put the number one, the most important, at the top, justice. Our biggest problem in this country is not politics. We have an injustice in the White House. And if we don't make that right, God's going to continue to bring punishment against this nation. And so I want to remind you, though, that on Friday, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a very special guest here on the program with us, a gentleman by the name of Mark Davidson. He's a student of Bible prophecy and world history and geopolitics and economics. His research has shown that a proper understanding of ancient and medieval history reveals what the prophetic book of Daniel is trying to tell us will happen in these end times. He's going to be on here with us, and he's going to be talking about his book. He has a new book as well called Daniel Revisited. His first edition was called Hidden in Plain Sight, Bringing About the Truth. He's appeared on many television shows and radio shows. He's going to be on with us on Friday. He's a graduate. He's an engineer. He works in the field of system engineering. And he lives, of course, here in the United States with his dear wife. We're going to encourage you to come on board with us. We're going to be doing that on both shows. Brother Mark Davidson will be on with us in the morning show and the afternoon show. And you can call in and ask him a question. He's going to be dealing with the rapture and tribulation. He's going to be dealing with what the book of Daniel, chapter 7 and chapter 8 say. And I would encourage you to make sure that you come on our show on Friday. Now, that's one day after tomorrow. Today's Wednesday. Tomorrow's Thursday. Then we'll be on Friday. And you can, Mark says, Daniel revisited that the second horn of Persia, which has grown up longer and later than the first horn, has been fulfilled. So we're going to be talking about prophecy. Friday is going to be Prophecy Day, and we're going to have Mark Davidson on talking about his book, Daniel Revisited, and we would encourage you to be a part of that. And by the way, I want to remind you that we are busy about getting together our final touches on David's tabernacle here, where people can come 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and be a part. And we thank the Lord for that. Now, I'm going to make another phone call here and get on another program, I'm hoping. See if I can get on that program with them. Hang on with me just a second.
Log Talk Radio. Your show is scheduled to start in 1 minute, 1 second. Welcome to Log Talk Radio. Please hold and you'll be able to listen to the show. Now in the host queue.
Ladies and gentlemen, this program that's on, we'll be coming on in about 30 seconds. It's the North American Law Center, and they're going to reveal some more details about where's Obama's birth certificate and some of the other legal matters that we need to deal with. So we encourage you to stay tuned. You're going to hear a little music in the background, but they'll be on in just a few minutes. So Eugene and this is Pastor Wiley Drake, and Michael Bolin suggested that I call in on the show, and you put me up in the queue.
Okay. All right. I got you listed.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks for calling in.
You're welcome. Okay. We're going to put the music down over here if we can. I'll try to listen for the music so you don't have to. But Eugene and Goldie, you have anything else you'd like to share?
Well, I'd like to know if you ever got your vice president to give any of the looks to the justices of the Supreme Court. That shows we're really for real because you're giving it right to them.
Well, she's not on the line with us right now, and I don't know. I do know she's working on it, but you know, Washington, D.C., you have to go through this one and that one and the other one, and it's hard to get to those guys. They run from you like scared rabbits. It's like going in the kitchen late at night and turning the light on. All the cockroaches go running to the corner.
Well, what we got is, no, I'll tell you what, Pat.
Hang
what
on just a minute.
We went and delivered the letters of this fraud.
Listen to this charge, this challenge project that we're working on to try to find justice for this country. And the way to do it is through Smith, through investigation, the truth out. So, sincerely, we really appreciate those of you that are online and on the phone, working with us, trying to help move this project forward. I want to thank Birth Report for their continued support. Mona and Ruth, they're going to be in the screening room this evening. Now, tonight's call, we're going to be, it's going to be more of an educational call because there's a lot of things floating around about impeachment that folks aren't familiar with. Now, there's people that think that if we impeach the president, it's going to legitimize his presidency, therefore everything that he's done can't be reversed. Well, I don't know that that's true. So maybe we can clear some of that up. Also, if he's impeached, maybe he won't be charged with some of the crimes he's been alleged to have done. When we're talking high crimes and misdemeanors for a presidential for president, with Barack Obama, it's high crimes and felonies, not just misdemeanors, felonies. Something else, earlier this year, there was some congressman saying that we should impeach Barack Obama because of Benghazi and what was going on in there, and it got me to thinking, Trey Gowdy right now is going after who? Hillary Clinton? Reminds me of a scene from Blazing Saddles where they've got a horse and a rider up on the gallows, and they're going to hang both of them, the horse and the rider. Well, they're going after the wrong person. They're going after the horse. The person they need to be going after with Benghazi is Barack Obama. It's just, it's almost so stupid, it's funny. But
well, you're absolutely right. It is funny.
Hillary Clinton, the horse.
There we go.
So, and tonight we're going to have Karen Bracken, J.B. Williams, Barbara Cate, and Colonel Harding, Stephen Pigeon. And just for the first minute here, I'm going to open up the mic.
Unmuted.
We're going to have Pastor Wiley Drake, presidential candidate with Alan Keyes. He was vice president. Mr. Drake, glad to have you with us this evening for just a few minutes.
Well, thank you so much. I appreciate the opportunity. This is Wiley Drake, and I want people to know I'm not running with a party. I'm sick and tired of the Republican Party. I'm sick and tired of the Democratic Party. I'm sick and tired of party, party, party. We must have a man of God, and that's why I'm running for president on the Bible, nothing else but the Bible, no party politics, just Bible politics, because that's what this country was founded on. Most people don't even know this today, but most of our early presidents were also pastors. Most of our politicians were pastors. And somehow we let the rest of the world take over, and we need to get back to men of God in godly positions. And when the Bible says, when a righteous man rules, the people rejoice. But when the evil men rule, like Barry Satoru, now some of y'all know him as Barack Hussein Obama, that's not his name. And if you want to find out the evidence on that, don't take my word for it. Go to wheresobamasbirthcertificate.com and get the whole evidence packet. My case is the one, Drake v. Obama, that went all the way to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court kicked it out. They said we didn't have standing. Dr. Alan Keyes was once the ambassador to the UN. I was in Vietnam for two tours of duty. If those kind of men don't have standing, who the heck does? And so we're fighting. We'll keep on fighting. And I would ask for your vote when the election comes up next year in 16.
Well, Pastor Drake, thank you so much for joining us on the call, and thank you for that message. We really appreciate it. You're absolutely right. We really do need some more Christians in leadership, because it's certainly not there now. And thank you for the message. Thank you for the work that you did on Capitol Hill, too, trying to get justice for this country, and the work you did, like what we're trying to do here, too. So thank you very much, sir, and God bless you.
Well, thank you, and I appreciate it. He has blessed us, and we'll continue to work and help any way we can.
All right. Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate you coming on.
All right. God bless.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for that, but that was another show that is on, and it's called the North American Law Center. We're involved with them. We're also involved with Eugene and Goldie. Are you guys still with us?
I'm here.
Okay, very good. And we indeed want you to continue to pray for Bill and Eugene and Goldie, and they're traveling and doing their work. Pray for my vice presidential candidate, Blossom Brackman. She has the copies of that book that we talked about, The Death of the Justice System, and we're trying to get them delivered to the U.S. justices there at what's referred to as SCOTUS, Supreme Court of the United States. But in all honesty, we've been sent up and down the halls, up and down the stairs, sent everywhere but to the bathroom to be sent. And we have not been able to deliver one of those books yet, but we're still working on it.
You see, if they see it, Pastor, then they got to do something. It'll be our word against their word, and they can't handle that because they have to answer it.
Yeah.
And they can't answer it. They answer it, everyone gets their tapes. And when everybody's so, it doesn't matter how long ago, it could be 80 years, there's no statute of limitation. I'm brought on the court or by the court. Don't forget, your lawyer is an officer of the court. That he's committing the crime to not giving you the tape. The judges, everyone else are officers of the court. If they know there's a crime, if they know there's tape, they've broken the law. So they can't look at it. They can't see it. They don't want to see the writ of certiorari because they must feel that stuff was wrong when he said, I can't give you your tape. Because everybody will want theirs, and they'll be playing them on TV every night.
Yeah.
That means he knows there's a part going on in the courtroom.
Amen.
And straight out, we'll sign an affidavit to that for anybody's case that wants it. Or just throw the book on the court case, on your court case, and tell them to answer it.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. Go ahead.
Well, you know, there's fraud in Eugene's case. Pastor Drake, there's fraud in your case.
Yes.
That's right.
You know? And the chances of you got to prove the fraud in your case, too. They're making it very difficult for everyone just to, we abide by the law. Why don't they have to abide by the law?
See, the difference is, Pastor, I won. And I know it's right. They gave me a check for $250,000. And I was supposed to come back, and they hid my doctor's report. That's Jan Fawcett. And we have that man over there, Rosenthal, at Chapman College. He stole it out. Now, you can't say things like that right on the air unless you can prove it, and we can prove it. We have the evidence, and it's not in my writing. They wrote it. Cheryl Young, they admitted to cheating on the dockets, changing transcripts. They've done it to all of you, but the people out there weren't looking for the simplicity of the cheating. That's why in the book I say to everybody, did you ever think you might be cheated?
Mm.
And that's why your briefs aren't any good and your stuff isn't any good? That's what this is. Or
yeah.
The court system might be a wonderful system. It's the people in the system. And you're voting and paying for all this.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, this is like unbelievable once you read the book and realize how much fraud's going on. And we stand behind it 100%. Just, as I told you, we write a deposition to your affidavit, anything you want.
And they had it locked up. Nobody can get to the Supreme Court. They locked the Supreme Court up.
Yeah.
Lucky I got in. I'm in there. You can see the writ of certiorari, and they don't know who denied me. They don't know nothing, because if they answer that question, they open the door for everybody.
Yeah.
That's the key question. Where are my tapes?
Yep. Amen.
Where are your tapes? Where is everybody's tapes? We're in a vault. The master tape is in a vault. The other ones are in the court reporter's machine. But here's the point. Don't let them take them away. You got to get it right then and there, like Johnny Cochran did in the O.J. Simpson case.
Yes, amen.
Johnny Cochran was a state attorney. He knew what they were doing. I know what they were doing because I was brought up in Chicago with this stuff. I mean, God, they can't tell me any kind of lies. You can't sit on the radio and say this stuff unless you can back it up.
Yeah, absolutely.
And we can back it up. Every single thing that's in that book is absolutely true.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the book...
They're cheating parents. They're cheating prisoners.
Yeah.
They're cheating divorce courts. They have terroristic divorces now where one party doesn't even stand a chance. If the judge doesn't even obey the law, your lawyer you hire is in on it too, and you can't figure out why you're not winning, because this is the law. It says it's the law, but the judge... does just the opposite of the law, and it's in everybody's case. Every judge is doing it. Every lawyer is doing it, and there's a way out. Eugene has carved the path straight to the Supreme Court for all of us. It's like going to heaven. He's got the ladder to heaven. It's similar to that, and it doesn't get any better than the ladder to heaven. No.
Amen.
So we're looking forward to selling the books and waking people up to what's going on in the court system and why they're taking the kids and why they're cheating everyone. And Eugene puts it out there in his book really easy for everybody to understand in a simple manner, that the world will see that everyone's being cheated.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, she's absolutely right. And there's two things that I would encourage you to get. Number one is the evidence package in our case. And that evidence package is entitled, Where's Obama's Birth Certificate.com. You can go online and download that. You don't have to do anything except download it and print it. You have to have plenty of ink and plenty of paper, but you do have to download. That's a complete evidence packet that was put together by Sheriff Joe Arpaio, Mike Volan, and other folk that put it together. Our attorney, Orley Tate, our other attorney, Gary Creep, and all that evidence has been put together, and it's there in the evidence packet. Get that packet and read it. It's called Where's Obama's Birth Certificate.com, and you can get that. And then, if you have a case that you need to work your way through and find your way through to reveal the fraud, get this evidence packet. This evidence packet is entitled, The Death of the Justice System. The Death of the Justice System. And if you want to get that, you simply go to www.crownoakpress.com. CrownOakPress.com, and I would encourage you to do that, and thank the Lord for that. And by the way, Eugene, we left those books with our vice presidential candidate, but we also had that second box that was there at the hostel, and I don't know if those have been returned yet or not, but we need to check that out probably.
Oh, thank you.
And thank you so much for both of you being on. And anyone else on the line that would like to ask a question or share anything, I want to remind you that on Friday we're going to be doing a show on prophecy on the last days. We're going to have some people that are very expert in the field, and we're going to allow you to ask questions if you'd so like to do so. We're working in Washington, D.C. Want to remind you folks that there are some good things coming out of Washington, D.C. One of them is a thing called the Jefferson Gathering. Every Wednesday night, tonight in just a few minutes, they're going to be having a worship service in the Capitol. In fact, the matter is, it's probably coming to an end right now because it's pretty late back there. But every Wednesday night, the members of Congress and the staff on the Hill go to an interdenominational Christian worship service in our Capitol. And I would encourage you to be a part of that. Pray for those men who lead that. I want to give you some names to pray for. And that is, first of all, Pastor Jim Garlow down in Texas is the oversight pastor. And also leading the worship there in the Capitol. You know, when Jefferson was president, they had church there in the Capitol every week. And now it's happening again. But one of the men who leads in the worship is a pastor by the name of Steve Emerson, A-M-E-R-S-O-N, and he leads the worship. And the pastor is a man by the name of Dan Cummins. Dan Cummins is a convening pastor. And I would encourage you to pray for me. I'm going to be in Washington, D.C., the week of November the 9th. And on the 11th, I've been invited by Dan Cummins to attend that midweek service. And I've also invited my congressman, Ed Royce. I don't know whether he'll be able to go or not. They have a lot of voting to do, I know. But I have invited Congressman Ed Royce because he's a good man. And I've invited him to meet with myself, with Dan Cummins, with Pierre Bynum from the Family Research Council. And we're going to be there all week long, and we hope to meet with this congressman. And we're hoping that he'll join us for church in the Capitol on Wednesday night and be there with us. If not, we hope he'll meet with us other days. We'll be there all week long. And we thank the Lord for the opportunity to be there. And we trust and hope that you'll be back with us tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be talking more about worship. We're going to be talking more about worship and fasting and praying. You know, Jesus didn't come up with this idea and say, well, you know, I have a pretty good idea that might work. That is fasting. No, Jesus said, when you fast. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not a scholar, but I did study Greek and Hebrew in the seminary. And when it says, when so-and-so happens, that doesn't mean it might happen or it could happen. When it says when certain things happen, that means it does happen. And that's why Jesus used that Greek phrase to say, not if you fast, not maybe you should fast, but when you fast. That means you will fast, according to Jesus. So we're going to be talking tomorrow morning more about prayer and fasting. We're going to be talking more about worship service, not only in the Capitol, but in David's tent near the Capitol, and in David's tent in Nashville, Tennessee, as well as David's tabernacle or tent right here in our church, right here in Buena Park. And we want you to know that Buena means good. So it's going to be in Good Park that we're going to be worshiping and praising the Lord. And we would encourage you, join us tomorrow morning on this conference call line. And if you're watching us and you don't have the conference call line, let me give that to you right now. The number that Goldie and Eugene called in on is 712-432-1690. And after you call that number, you put your access code in, 399-430-POUND, 399-430-POUND. Now, let me say to you in reference to the legality of things, sometimes people want to call in on a conference call line and they're afraid that somebody is going to identify them. Well, you do not have to identify yourself when you come on this program. We do ask you to do it, but if you don't, that's okay. We're not going to be upset with anybody if they don't do it. And but someone asked me the other day about that access number. If I put that access number in from my phone, won't they be able to identify me? No, that number doesn't identify you. That number simply gives you access into our board here, into our system, so that you can talk. It does not identify you in any way. If they check that number, it will have Wiley Drake's name on it, because that's my number and my access code. So you don't have to worry about losing your anonymity if you call in. So call in 712-432-1690. After you get that in, it'll ask you for your access code. Put it in. That's 399-430-pound. And we would encourage you to put that in there. Now, Eugene or Goldie, anything else you'd like to share?
Yes. Goldie is here. Eugene got dropped off somehow. I don't know how. He's gone. But I just want to say thank you for this opportunity today. And I want to say, excuse me, that I really enjoyed your trumpet playing. when you blew your, it's called a tie.
Well, it's...
All
right, well, let me do that. We didn't do that earlier in the show, and I forgot it, and we have time. The Bible calls it in the English Bible the trumpet, but in the Hebrew, it's the word shofar, S-H-O-F-A-R, and the call is takia in the Hebrew. It means to call to worship. Trumpet of God. The Bible teaches us that we're to blow the trumpet for worship. We're also to blow the trumpet for repentance and confession. We're also to blow the trumpet just like they do at the football game. That means charge. And we play it at sports times, but we also play it at battle times. We also know that in the Bible it says that God's people were told by God to bring the wall down. And the way they were to bring the wall down was to break their pitchers and show their light, and the trumpet of God would be sounded and the walls came tumbling down. Ladies and gentlemen, do you have a wall in your life? Do you have a wall of drugs, alcohol, a wall of depression? A wall of whatever might be bothering you? All you got to do is get your shofar, blow the shofar, and the wall will come tumbling down. You can find shofars all over the internet. You can find them as cheap as $30-$40 or a couple of $100, whatever you want to buy, however big or however. The bottom line is, folks, the more you pay, the easier they are to blow. So don't get a cheap one unless you got a lot of wind. But at any rate, the shofar, the trumpet of God, the trumpet of praise, the trumpet of confession. And the Bible says one day after all of these trumpet blowings have happened, all of these criminal cases have gone by the wayside, the Bible says, then we which remain and are alive will be caught up together to be with them in the sky. And that happens when the Bible says, and the final trumpet shall blow. And that final trumpet is a going home call. When God calls me and you home, God himself is going to blow the shofar. And we're going to be ushered into the very presence of the highest justice in all of eternity. And he's going to look at us and say, nothing you have done will justify you coming to heaven. Unless I know you and have a personal relationship with you. So whether it's Goldie, Eugene, Brother David Meyer here, myself, or others, if you do not know Jesus, he doesn't know you. And if you want to come to know Jesus, the way you do that is simply confess your sins, repent, as the shofar would call you to do, and say, dear Jesus, come into my heart and into my life. And then when the final trumpet is blown, the final trumpet will be blown, and you will be ushered into the presence of Almighty God. Not because you're Baptist, not because you're Pentecostal or Catholic or something else, but you'll be ushered into the presence of God because he will say, come unto me, all my children. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a child of God. Yes, I'm a pastor. Yes, I'm a broadcaster. Yes, I'm a politician. Yes, I'm all kinds of things, but I'm going to heaven not because of any of those. I'm going to heaven when I die because I have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And I would encourage you, if you don't have that, please get it right today. And I promise you, we will meet one another in heaven one of these days. Well, Goldie, we're going to go. We're going to call it quits just a little bit early tonight.
And thank you again.
All right. God bless you, and thank you for being on with us.
God bless you, too. Now, real quick, is it okay I put all your stuff up on my page, too, on the Death of the Justice System?
Absolutely. Send me an email.
Okay, I just wanted to be sure it's okay with you.
That's fine, but send me an email so I can know how to find it, okay?
I will do that.
Thank you very kindly. God bless you.
I've already added you. You're already on there.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
I did add you to the page. You could probably, but I'll email it to you anyway. But I did add you on there.
Okay, thank you so much. God bless you and have a great evening.
Thank you. Bye-bye. God bless you too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.